All right, so here's how the parking pole assembles. You got your pin, got your parking pole here, got your spring right there and right there. And then you just take your thumb and slide it into this groove here. Now you can put your governor housing back on. Jiggle those little pieces in right there, line up these bolt holes, kind of give it a little shake and shimmy. Don't have to force anything, it'll just slide back together. Then we'll put these bolts on and slide in that tail shaft. Okay, working on the sprag. Now the sprag is a one-way roller clutch. These springs have to go in one way. Take a look at this spring. This side is open down. This side has a little curve to it, and that little curve is going to support that roller. And so we take this, we slide it in like this. And then we just take this screwdriver, we hold that over while we slide. Actually, you can just push that in too. Depending upon when you first get rolling, you have to use your screwdriver to get it to go. But once you get it going, you can sometimes slide those little ball bearings in there. Then you take your centerpiece and you roll it on in there, this piece here. You take the centerpiece and you carefully keep it centered as you roll it in, and then you can check and see it. It rolls this way, it locks this way. And these springs here, the old springs, are about two-thirds as long as what these new springs were. I got this sprag rebuild kit from a transmission parts dealer on eBay. So sprag is rebuilt, sprag is ready to go in. Then we will put together the governor housing and put the shaft in. Okay, now this is that conversion. The sprag is a little bit thinner. It's been machined for this Torrington bearing. You can see it's nice and smooth on this side. We will put some lube on this face. We're going to put some lube over here for the thrust washer. Now the first thing we put in there was the centering ring. That keeps everything centered. Then we have the thrust washer. That keeps the wear off the aluminum surface. And we lube it up nice so that we don't have any problems on startup. Then we come in with the Torrington bearing. We're going to lube it up. Lay that in there on top of that thrust washer. Make sure it spins okay on that sleeve we installed. Then we're going to put this sprag in. We'll put the transmission case like this. We'll just slide a bolt in to one of these holes as we hold this in there and line it up. Okay, you can see we've got the bolts in. We've got them torqued down. The sprag is right there. And everything looks like it stayed in place like it oughta. So now we will do the park brake pawl and everything else. Okay, you can see the pin, the pawl, the spring. See how that spring goes? Got the roller bearing lined up here with that lever that actuates it. Then the actual roller mechanism with the spacer, the bushing there. Everything has been greased up with Vaseline. Then we line up these tubes. And we just shimmy everything gently together and lining up the tubes and the bolt holes. And everything just slides together. Then we put the bolts in right in these holes here. Okay, we have the tail shaft. And if you look real close here, you can see how these are split cut. See that there? They got a kerf on the edge. And you just make those kerfs line up to where they fit together properly. And so that is ready to slide in. So let's do that. All right. So that fits real nice. So what we need to do now is turn our attention to putting the rest of this together. The next thing, set that up here. This piece here, see that bushing? Got it looped up, and that goes with the sprat. Just kind of rotate it around in there till we get things lined up and going the way we want. There we go. And it spins one way real nice, and it does not spin the other way. And that's exactly what we want to see. All right, so the next thing we're going to do is put this new bushing in. That matches the one that came out. That's a new bushing. The other ones were kind of worn. So we'll stick down the back with Vaseline and lube the front. And then these little tabs here go into the little holes that locate that bushing, holding it into place. Then next goes the carrier, and it goes this way because then the reverse planet will go right there. So we slide this rascal in here, it goes down, and now we put the C-clip in, and then we've got this basic part done to where nothing falls apart, and we can turn our attention to other things. I like doing things in segments. Some people like to do it all together and get it all done in one assembly session, but I like to do it in segments to make sure that I don't miss details and that I don't lose parts. I'm able to concentrate better on what I'm doing when I do it in subsets. So take your pick, make sure that we are in that groove nice and solid and everything looks like it ought to, which it does. And now you can see everything is taken care of there. The next thing we'll do is turn our attention to the governor, and then I'll put the tail housing on. Then we'll go back and do the reverse band and some of those other things. But let's get this governor out on the bench, show you how to clean it up and put it back together, and so you'll know what you're doing. Okay, this here's the governor. You'll see it has two sides, the major side and the minor side. And this minor side in here, you take a screwdriver and you kind of push that spring back while you push that part up. And this over here, it has a clip that you take out with your snap ring pliers. Now there's a little bit different kind of snap ring pliers, and you can flip this over here, give it a click, and now it does outside. Flip that lever back, now it does inside. Kind of a handy little tool to have if you got the room to work with it. It doesn't work in really tight places because it's a pretty big size tool, but it sure is a handy one to have on the bench. And then of course take it apart with your finger over everything so you can make sure how it comes apart with the spacer and the C-clip, the valve, which got some dirt in there, and then the spring. So it's going to need a good cleanup. Like we talked about before, if you're going to have trouble with shifting problems, it's going to be in the governor because of the dirt. So take and push down on that spring so you can get this little plate out. Make sure you keep your finger on stuff. Make sure you notice how the plate goes in. See those little lock tabs? Okay, so the plate goes in with those lock tabs up, then the spring, and then the valve. Notice how the valve comes out, small side in, big side out. And so now we'll clean this rascal up. Okay, so we've got this all cleaned out, blown out, nice, clean. We're going to go back together. And so what we'll do is lube it up with some transmission fluid. We don't want that stuff sticking. We'll put that in there. Make sure it goes all the way to the bottom okay. Kind of rattle it around, make sure that everything moves around like it should. Hear that? Move it nice and free, rattling. Put that spring in there. And then we're going to slide that plate back in there. And while we had it apart, we made sure that everything, work with that spring a little bit as we go in, and now we got her locked into place. Looks like everything oughta. Looking good. Make sure that, part of the thing is, I clean my hands the best I can, but this transmission fluid has so much detergent in it that it will take any dirt on your fingers and put it into that valve, that governor. You don't want that. You got to be careful. All right. So we'll put this together. Okay, got my valve lubed up. Spring, small side of the valve that rests against that spring right there. Then we get this rascal in, make sure she moves nice and easy. Then comes our spacer. Then comes our C-clip. Not quite in. Just gonna work it a little bit. Get it pushed in until it snaps where it needs to be. Make sure it stays where you want it. Make sure we get all the any dirt of any kind. I'm going to blow it out. Make sure. All right, on the governor, you've got a hole right here, hole right here. Both of the pressure holes, they go towards the minor side. So we put this on like this, and then we take our bolts and just simply install the governor. And then we'll snug it up. ⅜ inch. All right, and got it nice and snug here. Spins good. Feels good. So we ought to be fine to go back and start assembling the rest of that transmission. On the tail shaft, I'm gonna have to show you guys how to repair a bolt hole. They had stripped out the bolt on the speedometer gear and they just took a big old lag screw and stuck it in there. So we'll get that repaired, get the tail shaft on, and then we'll get to working on the rest of the internals.